then from there on, we actually took it a step further and checked on what we call the actual implementation of what we discussed. So today, I want us to take it further and now have a look at what we call GitHub Copilot. So GitHub Copilot, and I want to be very keen with the time today. I want us to be done at exactly 10 sharp. So at 10:50, I'll be done presentation and I will have 5 minutes of questions, 10, another 5 minutes for responses, and then we can call it a day. So what is GitHub Copilot? GitHub Copilot is an artificial intelligence tool that uses machine learning to provide intelligent suggestions and auto-completion for developers while they are writing code. It is powered by the OpenAI's GPT-3 and GPT in full, that is what we call generative pre-trained transformer. And we have the various versions. We have 3, we have 3.5, we have 4, which are language models and works as an extension for Microsoft Visual Studio Code Editor. So GitHub Copilot uses natural language processing to understand the context of the code being written and suggest code snippets, function calls, and even entire functions to complete the code. It can help developers to be more productive by reducing the time and effort to write complex code. That is about GitHub Copilot. Also, GitHub Copilot is not designed to replace developers, but rather to augment their skills and improve their workflow. I think we really need to understand that GitHub Copilot is not designed to replace developers. It is designed to augment our skills and improve our workflow. So it has the potential to revolutionize the way developers write code by providing intelligent suggestions and reducing the cognitive load required to write code. GitHub Copilot is fine-tuned with open source. It generates novice code based on the context, not just a random autocomplete extension. So let me get a little deeper to explain these concepts to make more sense. So when we say GitHub is fine-tuned with open, I mean GitHub Copilot is fine-tuned with open source, this is to mean that most of the final details or the training of the Copilot has been done using data which is open source. This could be some of the public repositories that are available on GitHub. And so that is what has been used to train it so that when we try to write a code, it tries to get the context of what we write, and then it gives us the suggestion that will probably be what we need. And that is what we call the autocomplete. Now, it generates novice code based on content, on context. This is to mean, let's say you are writing an application that is for Python, maybe automation. So when you are in a Python environment, GitHub Copilot will give you the most probable completion that you will get. You will get based on the Python language and also based on the context of what you're trying to write. For example, if you're trying to write something like maybe to automate the copying of files, most of the suggestions that you will get will most likely be something related to copying of files or that automation. Also, you need to know that GitHub Copilot is not just a random complete extension. That should you take into consideration. And also, GitHub Copilot is compatible with the popular VS Code and other popular JetBrains IDEs. JetBrains IDEs, this is where we talk about things like PyCharm, we talk about IntelliJ, we talk about WebStorm, PHP Storm. So JetBrains IDEs, they all support GitHub Copilot. GitHub Copilot can still be used with GitHub Code Spaces. So Code Spaces, this is the ability, like a feature that allows you to automatically like write code on your GitHub repository. You don't need to install any IDE. You don't need to install any packages. Just write on your GitHub repo. You can be able to write your code and do everything that you will have otherwise done locally on your VS Code. So still while using what we call code spaces, you can still be able to use GitHub Copilot. You also need to know that GitHub Copilot is premium, but if you are a student in a verified university, you can be able to use GitHub Copilot for free. And I'm going to show you how to activate Copilot for free as a student. So GitHub Copilot is just some kind of an AI enhanced problem solving. So what are some of the use cases where you can use GitHub Copilot? You can use Copilot to optimize your algorithm, debugging and error solution. And most of us, I'm pretty sure that our day-to-day use of Copilot is debugging and error solution. You know, you write your code, line number 1 to number 50. All of a sudden, your code isn't right, and you get some errors on the terminal or on the console. You can actually just highlight that section of the code, give it to GitHub Copilot, and it will help you fix that. Things to do with if you have a code that is set to use Prettier, Prettier for code formatting. GitHub Copilot can help you format that if it's an error. And I'm going to show you how to get those suggestions using Copilot, where you'll see a pop-up menu that tells you fix with Copilot. So there's a lot more we're going to do. So collaborating with Copilot, you can use it in real-world scenarios, for example, hackathons, team projects, and etc. Assume a scenario where you have a hackathon. Hackathon usually goes for just a day or just 2 days. So to speed up your development during this activity like a hackathon, you can use GitHub Copilot to help you write faster, because it's like you having a pair programmer. You write, you need suggestions, tell Copilot, okay, we're implementing this. It can also help give you the architecture really quick so that you can focus on building, solving the problem than writing the code. So we also have, you can combine Copilot with GitHub Actions for CI/CD automation. When we talk about CI/CD automations, what we mean is continuous integration and continuous deployment. This is a feature that allows you to automatically ship new features to a production environment by just pushing them to a targeted branch on your GitHub repository. And Copilot can help you generate those workflows and to ensure that your tests are running as you expect. Okay, moving forward. So it has some challenges. For example, potential biases in AI-generated code. So some of the time you'll find that the suggestions you get while using Copilot, some are some of the code that you will find when you now go to public repos, right? So you will find that it has some code taken directly from public repositories. And also, over-reliance and the need to review suggestions. Most of us who use Copilot, you find that you just prompt it or just tell it, this is what you need. It does that. But we need to actually review what it has provided, because it can make mistakes. So most of the time when you prompt or get suggestions or auto-completions, you need to actually review the response that you get and ensure that it is what you need and that it has no errors. If it has errors, you can at least fine-tune your prompts so that it can give you exactly what you want. Another thing is how GitHub ensures data privacy and intellectual property compliance. And this is some of the point I was saying. In some cases, you'll find that the completions that you get are actually references from other people's repositories. And so this brings in the issue of what we call data privacy and intellectual property compliance. So that is like a soft overview of what Copilot is all about. And now allow me show you how you can first activate your free Copilot as a student, so that you can start using Copilot as your AI pair programmer to make your workflows easy, to build faster, and this will enable you to focus on the code, on solving the problem, than focusing on the code. So that is for the presentation I have for what we call Copilot. So at this point, allow me stop sharing my PowerPoint so that I can share my screen, so that we can get practical and actually see how to install, integrate, and have Copilot on our IDE. And in this session, I'm going to use Visual Studio Code for the demo. Thereafter, we are going to see how I can use Copilot to get auto completions. Also, I'm going to show you how you can use Autocopilot to write pull request messages, okay? To describe the changes that you've had on your code. So let me just stop that and share my screen from this moment onwards. So I will share my screen. Okay. So can you please confirm that you can see my screen if I continue? Great, thank you. So let's continue. And before we move forward to the demo, let me first show you how as a student, you can activate GitHub Copilot for free. So let me just bring along my new tab right here so that we can see it. Great. So for GitHub Copilot, you need something that we call a student GitHub Developer Pack. So GitHub Developer Pack gives you some benefits as a student. For example, one of the benefits you get as a student is you get a GitHub Pro. You get what we call Copilot for free. You get access to Azure credits as a student and 20 more resources on Azure as a student. So you need to come to your web browser and just Google. I want to make it so straightforward. Then search GitHub Student Pack. So on the first search result, you see we have GitHub Student Developer Pack. Education. So you'll dive into 6 months free access to over 70 practical courses covering hot topics like web development, Python, Java, machine learning, plus many, many more. So I'll click on this. Click on the first link. Once you click on that, that will take you to a page that will ask you to join the student community, GitHub community. Fantastic. So this is the page that you will get. So once you're in this page, we have GitHub Student Developer Pack. Just click on sign up for Student Developer Pack. So clicking on that will give you a form. In this form, you need to ensure that before you come here, your GitHub profile is complete with all the details, your name and email. And at this point, you will be required to input your school email address. Why? Because this is how they are going to verify that you are a student, you know? So if you have a student email address, so let's look at this. You have to choose, are you a teacher or a student? Select a student. Then coming down here, you see for mine, the first time I applied for this was way back last year, which already expired. And then I renewed it again. And you can see it's approved. And this was just recently in November 18th. So once you have this, you will have access to really, really a lot of resources. Then coming down here, you see you have to verify your school email address. So if your school email address is not right there, there's a way in which you can contact them and then they will help you set that up. Now, if I go to my GitHub account, I want to show you how it will look like once you are activated and you have the pro access. So just a minute, let me show you how that works. So I'm in my GitHub account, and if I come to my profile by clicking on this icon here, my profile picture here, let me click on that. Let me go to my profile. Then you see right down here, I have a pro badge, which means I'm a student, I pay nothing, but I have the pro access to GitHub. This will come in handy because it will get access to code scanners that will scan your repositories for API keys that are exposed, and it will alert you. So on that, let me share with you a link to help you follow up step by step how how to actually activate your own Copilot. So let me share that with you really quick on the chats. So on the chats, I've sent you a link from Microsoft Educators. So follow that link. You will get a step-by-step procedure on how to activate your Copilot. So that is it. So from there, now let's go to our VS Code, because we're now on the practical bit to make things practical. So I will set up my VS Code. Let me minimize this tab. So let me set up my VS Code right here. And I want to show you how we can start working with Copilot right away on VS Code once you get access to it. Let me, just a minute, it's starting up. It's kind of slow. Give it some time, it starts. Then I can show you how to use Copilot, how to install it, how to ensure it works, and then how to use it. Just hang on, it's starting right here so that we can show you that. So this is my Visual Studio Code starting up. So once it has started, I'll be able to show you how to set it up, install Copilot, how to use it. Okay, so it's setting up just real quick. We have to give it time so that it won't hang on us while we are on the demo. Great. So let me just open up the previous file that we used in our first session. So I'll come to Open Recent, and in our first session, we named our project Open Source. Click on that, and then now I can close on that in the background. So this is what happens. Now, remember those who are here in the last meeting, we had what we have here right now. Now, GitHub Copilot, you need to install it as an extension, okay? Now, with my extensions tab right here, let me just click on that. Just a minute. It's still hanging, but we're getting over this. It's gonna be okay. Great. So if I come to extensions tab here, and I just type what we call GitHub Copilot. So let it search, and we can see what we're going to get. Not really, that should be the extensions page here. Sorry, that was VS Code. No, I mean, this was JIT. This is the extensions tab. So when you click on the extensions right there, then coming up here, just type GitHub Copilot. And then you get the suggestions. You'll get all the suggestions right up on top here. Now you can see we have a number of GitHub code spaces. Then we have GitHub Copilot. So what you are referring to in our today's session is what we call GitHub Copilot. So if I click on Copilot, look at that. So I have it right there. So in your case, it is not installed. So you will get an install button here. So click on install. In my case, it is installed. And so I have access to GitHub Copilot. So when it's your first time installing GitHub Copilot, you'll be prompted to sign in. Why? Because remember, GitHub Copilot is not free. It's premium. And for students, it's free if you have the GitHub Student Developer Pack. So you need to sign in to get access to its features, all right? So once you have GitHub Copilot installed, if you check on your VS Code or what we call Visual Studio Code, on the bottom right corner, you will see something that looks like a Copilot icon, the same to this what we have here. You see we have this and this here. So this is what we have. So this one will show you the status of Copilot. Right now it is active. So this is what we call GitHub Pilot. Also, once you have Pilot installed here, like last time when we were making some commits, you'll be able to see some AI prompts. For example, if I come to source control, you can see we have something like AI completion here. And if I hover on that, generate commit message with Copilot, okay? So what I want to do is I want us to now try and test to see that GitHub Copilot is working and how does it work. So I'll close all the other files in my tab here. Let me close everything, close all. So I want to close everything there and then start working on a file. And we want to see how GitHub Copilot can help us move quickly. So coming back to my Explorer, I will start with index.html, right? So I have index.html, then I want to ensure that my Copilot is active. So let me zoom in to make things more clear so that you don't strain while viewing this. So I will just delete what I have here so that I have an empty body tag like that. So I only have the title and I have the body. Now, you see what happens. The moment I clicked, I removed everything, and then I ensured that my Copilot is active right here, I get some suggestions here. You see, I have a number of H1 and multiple P tags. It's because right now, I haven't given it any context. It doesn't know what I want to do. The only thing it knows is that I am trying to work with all open source, okay? So let me try and press enter. So once you get suggestions, and assuming this is a suggestion that you want to work with, this is what you want, you all you need to do is press tab, and then it will accept everything that you provide, okay? So once you get a suggestion while using Copilot, press tab to accept. I hope it's clear for that point. Now, I want us to take it a little step further and make it think wisely. How? Let me delete all the suggestions of open source here. And I want to just comment something here, like generate for me a navigation bar. If I press enter and then I give it time, what do we have? You see, it now knows what I want. What do I want? I want it to generate for me a navigation bar, okay? If I press enter, you see, it has some suggestions, and if I press tab instead, it accepts that. If I press enter, in most cases, it will even give you the closing tags. All I need to do is to press tab to accept. Okay? That is how to give it context. You can give Copilot context by just giving it comments that like acts like prompts. I can come here down and just add another comment. Generate a hero section with an image and some text. I need come enter and give it time. You see how it works? It already tells me all I need is a section. Once I have the section, you see it's not complete. In some instance, it won't give you a complete suggestions or completions. But it's a shortcut to even finding more suggestions. In your keyboard, you can use this combination. You press Control and Enter. Control and Enter will always come up with what we call different options or what we call suggestions. So look at this. We have suggestion one, we have suggestion two, we have suggestion three, suggestion four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10 suggestions, right? So from here, I come and go through all that I have here. And then once I find the exact or what I want, I simply accept the suggestion. So in this case, let me accept the last suggestion, suggestion 10. How do I do that? I simply click on accept suggestion. And that itself auto-completes everything that we have here. So let me do a word wrap to make everything visible here. You see, it has the section, image, P, but we are missing something. What are we missing? We are missing a section tab, right? So if I press enter, it will give me what I need to do is to accept the closing tag of the section tab. Look at that. So you can tell that based on the context where we are in, let me see if this will work. After the section, let me just press enter. Now you see it's already getting some context because look at this. It's even giving me the prompt itself. Generate a footer with some text, you see? Now, pressing enter, it starts to do that. You see what happens? Then the footer. Now, the only thing I did here is that I only prompted the first two prompts, like giving it hints, what I expect it to do. I like generate for me the action bar, it does that. I also came down here and told it, generate for me a hero section with an image and some text, okay? It did that. Coming down, now I haven't prompted it anything, but it already knows, okay, we might need some footer. So it prompted that, I accepted, and then it generated that footer right there. So that is how you can program in pair with Copilot. That is what that's why we call it AI pair programmer. Like it's like you are someone working alongside you. Okay. Now, let's say we are right here, and then I want to show you how sometimes you can fix errors using Copilot. Let me see where we can introduce an error to ensure that it works. Let's see. I want us to introduce some error anywhere and see if it will work. Or let's do that on the JavaScript side. Okay, now let me come to JavaScript. This is JavaScript. And the reason why I'm coming to JavaScript is to that we are using will always give you the suggestions, completions, based on the context of even the language you are using. So right here we are in JavaScript. So I can say, let section equals to document. Look at that. I don't have to type everything already, but it already shows me like section equals to document dot query selector dot section. If I want to accept this, I will just press tab. Okay. And that should work for me. If I change my mind, let's say I want to use other suggestions. You can still do this, what we did earlier, that is control and enter to give you more suggestions. Look at that. We have let section equals document query selector section. And then we have like contact list. You see what we have here, forms and everything. So because our code base right now is made up of few files, it has no more context. But the more you build, the more you write code, that's the more Copilot gets context from what you have already written to give you what you might need in your next iteration of code. Also, you notice that we have something like AI here. Let me see, hover on this and click on that. So code actions, you see what I was talking about? How to fix errors. If there's an issue or just you need to explain something, you will always have this icon here, the one that looks like a star. A bigger star and a smaller star. What they mean is that this is like an AI-enabled feature. If you've interacted the platforms that are AI-enabled, you can confirm that this is always the indication. So here, we can choose to fix using Copilot or explain what we have using Copilot. So let's try fixing using Copilot, but this macro will work if it has enough context. In some cases, it won't have the context and you need to give it more context. So let me click on fix using Copilot. So look at what is happening. It is generating something, it has generated, And once generated, let me close this. You see, we have query selector section. Once you see that this is exactly what you want, you accept. Before you accept, you need to ensure that you also read some explanation. Look at this. What is the problem? The problem is that the statement is incomplete. You need to complete the statement by specifying a property or method of the document. In this case, that is the query selector, and give it the argument that we want. And you can see it uses GPT-4o. Okay, that is the advantage of being a student and verifying your account. Once I'm satisfied that is what I want, I click on accept, and that should accept that solution. Okay, and if I highlight on this, click on this again, you see we have a number of things here. Remember when we started, we said you can use Copilot to enhance your code, enhance your algorithm, to help you fix errors, and even to refactor your code. Look, we have, you can modify using Copilot, review using Copilot, you can extract it to a constant in an enclosing scope, or you can also extract it to a function. So assume if I click on this, see what happens. Let section equals to new function, and then function, new function, return new document, query selector. So these are just but the tips of the icebergs of the capabilities that Copilot brings to you as your AI programmer. Okay, let me take you to another use case of Copilot that I mentioned earlier. I mentioned that Copilot can sometimes help you to write what we call PR messages. You have a branch. Right now we have what we call here. We have the login branch. We have the main branch. So if I come down here, let me first commit everything that we have here. Just click on the addition to stage them. And then coming on top here, we are using Copilot. Look at this. We're using Copilot to write a commit message. Click on that. This we did last time. I'm going to show you how to now write a PR message using Copilot. So see, this is very beautiful. Refactor, update contacts.js and index.html with navigation and hero section. And of course, that is what we just did. And then you commit that. And then let me push them. When pushing, you have constant, it will pull and push. So click it OK. So while that is happening, I want to create a new branch here. Git checkout. A new branch, and let's call this a Copilot message. Copilot message. So that will create first a new branch. Right down here, you see we have a new branch called Copilot message. So in this new branch, I just want to add a new file. So let me come here and add a new file. Let's HTML still, copilot.html. Then let's use Emmet abbreviation to complete. So here, I want to say my H1 testing Copilot ability to write PR messages. So I have this with me right now. So what I want to do is to push my branch or publish my branch. Then I will go to my repository, open a pull request. And remember, a pull request needs to have some descriptive information of what you have actually worked on. And I'm going to show you how, even if you have worked on a very large project, you've added a number of changes, Copilot has the ability to be able to summarize what you've done or worked on concisely, so that whoever is going to review your code can know from the word go what you've worked on. So let's follow the same steps. Stage these changes, commit them, or write the commit message first using Copilot. Look at this. This is a new feature. Add copilot.html for testing Copilot's ability to write PR messages and commit. Then now, because this is a new branch, we are going to publish a new branch. Click on publish. Before I publish, I want to take you back to my GitHub account. And we are going to open the same repo that we had last time. So here's my GitHub account. Let's open the same repo that we used last time for our open source study jam. So just coming up here, our repositories. Let me show you the repo. Yeah, still, actually we are on time. we expected. So yeah, remember this is what we used, Open Source Study Jam, and you can see it was updated 1 minute ago. So let me click on that. Once I click on our repository, you want to see that we only have two branches. But the moment I push the new branch, you will see how I'm going to open a pull request and write my pull request message using Copilot. So let's check. Right about now, you see we have no Copilot.html here because we've just tracked them, but we haven't pushed. Coming to check on the branches, we only have two branches, main and login. But we have a new branch called Copilot message. So let me come back and publish this branch. And our branch that we're publishing is what we call Copilot message. Once published, when we go back to our repo, we'll be able to see the new branch. From there on, I'm going to open a PR request to merge my branch into the main branch. So let's see. Good, that is done. So coming back to my repo, you see we have Copilot message had recent pushes 3 seconds ago. If I refresh on this page, let's see how many branches we have. We have how many branches? 3 branches now, and now we have Copilot message. Now let me compare and pull request. Click on that, because we want to open now a PR. Fantastic. Now, our title will come with our PR message, no, our commit message that we had written when pushing. Now, coming down here, we want to explain clearly what we have done. How do we do that? I can click on, you see what we have here, Copilot icon, click on that, and that will generate for you that PR message. So I'm clicking on that. Then we have summary of what we've done. Then it's doing that, generating summary. Look at this, summarizing the changes, and then it will print them right about here. Fantastic. See what we have. This pull request includes the addition of a new HTML file, Copilot. The file sets up a basic HTML document structure with a title, a header, and a header. And then you see what changed here. So from there on, I can just click on create a pull request. You see, after working on a feature for like a week, I don't have to go all the way writing down manually what I've added, what I removed. Copilot has the ability to do that for me. And then right now, open the pull request, I can just click on merge, and that confirm that, and that will merge it to our main branch. You can then choose either to delete that branch or just leave it there. And you can see right still, we still have something in preview, how to use Copilot to enhance your merge experience. So you can see how easy or how Copilot can help you program quickly, taking more of the coding work from you and leaving you to focus on solving the problem or the business logic of your application. And that's pretty much about what we need to know about Copilot when getting started. So with that, I think we can now take questions if there's any, and then I'll give their responses so that we can call it a day.
Okay, thank you very much for your presentation. So got a couple of questions in the chat. So the first one, that's my question. What are the other benefits of GitHub Student Pack?
Okay, let me show you other benefits of Developer Pack practically. Okay, so let's come here. Let me go back to my GitHub profile. It really has a dozen of what we call benefits. So when I'm on my homepage in my profile for GitHub, look here, I have a card here that says, go to GitHub Education. So let me click on that. Let me click on that to go to GitHub Education. I want to show you the very, very many benefits that GitHub Education brings to you as a student. So let it load. This is something that every student must have if you want to really get access to more resources, more training, more features. So let's see what we have. Great, it has loaded. So just hang on, I'll show you. Okay, now it's loading. So while it's loading, let me show you. Now let's see what we have. Student Developer Pack offers the following. If you see on top here, these are my claimed offers. These are offers that I've already claimed. One, MongoDB. I get access to $50 credit. I get access to free test certification. Namecheap, I get free access to a free domain. Symphonicast, things to do with PHP. I get access to a .tech domain. I get access to StreamYard, which is a streaming platform. Access to DataCamp, GitHub Pro, Thinkful, Namecheap, DigitalOcean subscription. I get access to Bootstrap Studio. Bootstrap Studio is like an application that allows you to build websites by just dragging and dropping components. Now, leave alone that, let's come to explore more offers to show you how beautiful this program is. So when we come here, you will get access to front-end masters, educative.to, get access to JitLens, get access to 1 month. Great. So coming down, look at this. We have Copilot, we have Markdown. Coming, we have AI prompting, but that's certifications. We have what we call security and monitoring down here. So just to come down and be specific on what you get, now look at this. Copilot, DigitalOcean, Namecheap, JetBrains IDEs. Look, when you have access to GitHub Pack, you get professional versions of JetBrains IDEs, all of them. You get access to Notion, Azure. I mentioned this, I already mentioned this. Heroku, DataCamp, Upright, Educative, Frontend Masters subscription for 6 months as a student, MongoDB, look at that, JetLens Studio. There's a lot of things you'll get from here. So you need to check it out. Screen bar, look at that. Icons, Mailgun. So I think I can advance at that in a better way. You also get access to Algo Experts. So yeah, that is it.
Okay, thank you very much. That's interesting. I didn't know that. Wow.
Yeah.
There are so many services. Thank you.
Yeah.
So the next question is it possible to give a web page image to Copilot to generate the HTML?
Please pardon me. I didn't hear you clearly.
Yeah, I was saying hello. That actually the question.
Okay.
Hello. Yeah. The question I in the chat. So if you don't hear, you can also check it. So it's asked by Lamin.
Oh, right here. Okay.
It says, yeah.
Is it possible to give a page image to Copilot? HTML. Not really. But there's a new feature that was released like last week on Visual Studio Code in combination with Copilot, though it's still in preview. It allows you to just give it a screenshot of a web page and it will generate for you a complete UI simply, automatically using Copilot and VS Code. So it's in preview. I'll check it out, then I'll mention it on our next meetup. That is on a Monday. Yes, so that is answered. So let's look at another question that we have here. Which VS Code extension you use to visualize the branches and commits? Okay, so you mean this one here and this one here? So this one here, the source control, this one comes with VS Code. You need not to install it. It will be there. When you install VS Code, it will be there. If it's there, you'll also have access to this one here. This one shows you your current branch. And if you want to switch, you can just click on it and click on main, and that will switch you to the main branch. So these are not extensions. They come inbuilt in Visual Studio Code. Just install Visual Studio Code and there you go. You have them right there. The source code, the source control extension and the visualization of the branches right down here. And also with this is what will enable you to use Copilot to write commit messages. Okay, that's, I think, answers our question. So how do you to compare branches? So to compare branches, how you do this? This is done automatically on your GitHub. You see what happened there? When I opened, let's see what we did. We were on, let me just navigate back really quick. So JitterBug knows what has changed from your previous branch to the new branch that is incoming. So it simply checks on what you changed, what you added, and what is new. Let me just see. We have open source. Open source study jam. Yeah, I think that is it. So this is something like you know to worry about. Once you have a new branch that has new features, and we have time. Let me do this really quick so that I show you. So let me just create a new branch really quick. This should take like 22 minutes. Git checkout. New branch. Let's say it compare. So in the compare here, I just want to add a new file. Let's say index. Function 2.js. Then generate for me a function that takes the strings. You see that? Let's do that. Okay, then the next thing we want is now the actual, you see how it's going to help me write this really quick, transpring, and that is it. Coming down here, I can now just do that. Okay, this not to work, this is just for them purposes. So after having this right here, I want to ensure that I've committed it. So let me just click on git status. Your function to untracked. Let me use the command line to push it really quick. So git add space period, and then also just combine it together and git commit. Let's call it a function. Fantastic. Then I want to push this function, this branch to the repository, git push, pushing it where to the origin, to which branch compare. Push origin compare. So this should push this branch to our repo. From there on, I'm going to show you how GitHub can highlight what has changed. So let's see that. Give it time to push really quick. We are running out of time. So I love that question so that it helps you actually. When you don't know how to compare branches, what has changed, you really have conflicts when you're working with a partner in a project. So let me show you that. It's almost, remember it's a network process, so it should go. Okay. While it's pushing, let me see if we have any other question. Okay, thank you for your presentation. I'll try Copilot. Okay, so let me see if it has pushed. Almost. Network. Let me try again. Hit push origin compare. Just a quick one. Let's see. Okay. My network seems to be so weak. But what happens once we have this one pushed to their remote repository? When we come back here, cannot retrieve the last comment at this time. Yeah, you see, I have a problem with the network. Let me refresh. Okay. I'll have to explain this just using by word. Oh, there you go. It is pushed. So let's do that quickly. Coming here, you see we have compare had recent pushes in the 16 seconds ago. Now look, we have pushed a new branch. Now, if you see our branches here, because of network, it can't load everything, but click on compare and pull request. Click on that. That will open. It's checking for manageability. So you see what is happening there? It is able to merge, okay? Now, what happens, scroll down here. See what has changed? showing one changed file with then additions and zero deletions. So when you have a big code, you'll see that this is what has been added. In this case, green, which means this is a new file or the file that has been changed. And because it has some green shades here, we added all these. If I go and change something else, you will see that it's marked as red. For example, if I delete function string line number 4, it will be a minus, but with a red shade color, telling you that is what was removed and this is what was added. So I hope that answers your question of how to compare branches. Yeah. Okay. Any question? Any other question that we have? Rointanko, do you have any other question?
No, I think everything is okay. All the question has been answered. I don't see any more.
Any other or anyone ask a question that you wanted to ask, but you haven't got the opportunity to ask?
No, I think actually the only question I had was about those student the student pack, because actually I've been hearing a lot about that student pack, but I've never tried it. So now I know the advantages and it's really awesome.
Yes, yes. Okay, so I think that will be our meeting today. And so if you want to learn more about Copilot, I'm sharing some links on the chat. So this will help you get deeper into learning Copilot, and you can try it on your own. Just ensure that you go to Microsoft, activate your GitHub Campus expert benefit, get access to courses. You'll get access to Frontend Masters, Scrimba, Educative, free credits on MongoDB, free certification on MongoDB or for any part of your choice. So that is it for our meeting. And on our next meeting on Monday, we are going to actually see how we can start contributing to open source by just having our own project. And we are going to do a demo on how you can write your code. I write my code, and then we bring them together and merge them into one product that can be shipped to production. So we have two more sessions to go. And also on the next week's session, we are going to have advanced topics on GitHub. For example, how to solve conflicts, how to like take it back, reverse changes, how to track the logs of Git to know what was done at what time, which commit caused our app to crash. You know, those are the nitty-gritties of Git that we need to know to be able to work with it efficiently and to be fit in an industry of any size. So thank you all for coming to this second session. And we hope to see you again next week on Monday and Wednesday when we'll do our last two sessions. So thank you very much, Rointanko. If there's anything from you.
Yeah, I think you have already concluded. Thank you so much for attending this session. And we hope we will see you again on Monday and Wednesday. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Okay, bye-bye. Everyone can leave at their pleasure. So we'll stop the recording.